ثم الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي عز فارتفع وذل كل شيء وخضع وفرج الأرض ووسع وفجد الأنهار فأنبع ونور نورا فشعشع وكلم موسى فأسمع فتجلى سبحانه للجبل فتقطع. وبعد، الصلاة والسلام على من أرسله الله بكتابه كالشمس وضحاها، وجاء بسنته كالقمر إذا تلاها، القائل في حديث القدسي: يا ابن آدم خلقتك للعبادة فلا تلعب، وتكفلت لك بالرزق فلا تتعب، وإن تلبتني ووجدتني وجدت كل شيء، وإن فتني فتك وفاتك كل شيء، وأنا أحسن إليك من كل شيء. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. All praise are due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the nourisher, the sustainer, the provider, the protector of all the worlds. Peace, blessings and salutations be upon your Aqa, my Aqa, the rising star of Medina, the intercessor of sinners, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, who was sent down to this world as rahmatan lil alameen, mercy unto the entire creation. To my respected brothers in Islam, mothers, ulama, qurra, huffaz, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Wa alaykum salam.
My brother here today, he has introduced me here. I never needed all of that. What he said, he's on top of my head, he's my senior. I'm nothing compared to him. As they say, a fiqh ruling is إِذَا جَاءَ الْمَاءُ بَطَلَ التَّيَمُّمُ, that when the water comes, then there's no need for tayammum, because the water is there, you can take wudu. That's how he is to me. But that is not my topic. We are here in this masjid on this blessed day of Yawm al-Jumu'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our presence here today. And for those who couldn't make it here due to sicknesses, illnesses, difficulties, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them. Ameen, thumma ameen.
Ameen.
We as human beings, if someone takes something from us, we tend to rise or to stand. Why? Because it does not belong to the next person. It's our right. It's our haq. When someone takes something from someone, that person will rise, he will stand, and he will fight for his right because it does not belong to the next person. And how many of us today give importance to the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has upon us? How many of us give importance to the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has placed upon us? Similar, when someone takes something from you, and when someone does anything wrong to you, it's up to you whether you want to forgive him or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive him. Why? Because it's not between him and Allah, it's between him and another servant of Allah. If that servant forgives you, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. The same way works with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That when you do not fulfill the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is up to him whether he wants to punish you or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed many rights upon us as his servants. Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam says in a hadith, Bunya al-Islamu ala khams. That Islam is based on five pillars. And these five pillars is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has placed upon us. What is this five pillars? Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam carries on by saying, Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. That to bear witness that there is no worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is his final and last messenger. And what's the other four pillars? Aqim salah. Establish your prayer. At zakah. Pay charity. Fast in the month of Ramadan. And go for hajj if you are able to do so. But I only want to talk about the four. Rights which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed upon us. Which is salah, fasting, zakah, and hajj. Salah is a great pillar of Islam. The difference between a Muslim and a kafir, it is salah. But how many of us today give importance to that great pillar of Islam, that right which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed upon us, that we have to fulfill? Look how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, how merciful He is upon us. Whether He wants to reward us or not is up to Him. Because it's His right, you have to do it, whether you like it or not. You have to fulfill the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But see how great He is. He rewards you for doing it. He rewards you for doing His right. What does Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? أول شيء يحاسب العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة. That the first thing a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be accountable for on the day of judgment, it is his salah. How are we going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that day if that is our first question to be asked? What are we going to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But it's sad to say today that we are neglecting that great pillar, that the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is narrated that if you miss one salah, you burn for 500 years in the fire of Jahannam. How many have we missed? How many have we missed? Today we are neglecting the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not give due importance to the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ السَّلَاةَ تَنَعَى مِنْ فَخْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. For indeed salah prevents you from doing wrong things. Look at the mercy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in salah. He says if you do salah, salah will protect you from doing wrong. Today we are neglecting that pillar of Islam, that right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has placed upon us. And it's up to Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to forgive us or to punish us, because it is His right. How many beautiful masjids are being built? The masjids are being beautified, big masjids are being built, but there's no one to make salah in that masjid. There's no one to make salah in that masjid. Where are we today? Where are we today? The Sahaba Ikram, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a great example for us. لَقَدَ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. For indeed in Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam you find the best of examples. Why don't we follow him? Why don't we follow Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam at the Battle of Karbala? When the family of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was slaughtered, Imam Hussein, he goes to Yazid, not for war, but for the farewell of the Muslims. He goes and he comes there. Before he comes to Yazid, Yazid sends an army to capture Imam Hussein and his family and all those companions that were with him. They were ambushed. They were surrounded. They couldn't do nothing for 10 days. For 10 days they were kept there. And the food that they had got finished. The water that they had got finished. This is the they captured by Yazid, they never forget the great act of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is salah. Well, they were not sitting there, being surrounded by the army, just sitting there worrying about what's going to happen to us. But they stood in salah. When the time for salah came, they made salah. They never forget the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they knew it was very important. They knew the punishment of it, and they knew the reward of it. Where are we today, respected audience? Where are we today? Can we show our faces to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Sahaba ikram used to cry because worrying about the Akhirah. Imam Hussein was the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the leader of the youth in Jannah, but he was still worried about the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who are we today? Who are we today? Respected audience, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding and guide us. Going on to the second right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is fasting. Ramadan goes and comes. But is there any change in us? Is there any change in us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That fasting has been made compulsory upon you as it's been made compulsory upon those before you. Each nation that came in this dunya, they had to fast. But what is the purpose of this fasting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us? He says in the end of the ayah, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that perhaps you may attain piety, that perhaps you may attain God-fearingness. Where are we? Ramadan goes and comes, but we're still the same. A question was asked from one Mawlana. He says, Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith that the shaitans, they are chained in Ramadan. They can't do anything, but why is it that we are still doing bad? Why is it that we are still doing bad? This Mawlana replied by saying that we are like a cup of tea and shaitan is the spoon. That when you stir the tea and you take the spoon out, what happens to the tea? It's still turning. So shaitan has been playing with us for 11 months. And we are so into shaitan that when Ramadan comes, it's our habit to do wrong. But look at the great personality. The great personality, Hazrat Abu Bakr. Abdul Bashir Ba'd al-Anbiya, the best of human beings after the Holy Prophet, after all the prophets, he's the best of creation. Hazrat Abu Bakr, he was that personality that said that if my one foot is in Jannah and my other one is outside, I still do not know if I will enter Jannah. Where are we today? He was that personality that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says about him, لَوْ وُزِنَ إِمَانَ أَبُو بَكْرِ بِإِمَانِ الْأُمَّةِ لَرَجَحَ إِمَانَ أَبُو بَكْرِ. That if you had to weigh the iman of the ummah and the iman of Hazrat Abu Bakr, the iman of Abu Bakr will outweigh the iman of the whole ummah. He was that personality that sits one day in the masjid. He sits in the masjid and crying on Eid day. He sits in the masjid, he's crying, weeping, his beard is wet. Other sahabas come to him, the other companions, they say, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ya Hazrat Abu Bakr, why are you crying? Why are you crying? And that was the same personality that went. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lays on the lap of Hazrat Aisha. And she looks up to the skies and she says, Ya Rasulullah, is there anyone with the good deeds as much as the stars in the skies? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied by saying, Yes, Hazrat Umar. She says, Ya Rasulullah, what about my father? Hazrat Abu Bakr. Rasulullah replies by saying that one of Hazrat Abu Bakr's good deeds and all the deeds of Hazrat Umar is not even equivalent to one of Hazrat Abu Bakr's good deeds. That was the status of this man, Hazrat Abu Bakr, this great personality. He sits in the masjid crying. The Sahaba asks him, why are you crying? This is a day of joy, the day of happiness. Why are you He replies by saying, I do not know if one of my fast is accepted in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at how great this personality is. Today Eid comes, we enjoy, we buy new things. But do we worry, is our fast accepted in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He was that man that was guaranteed Jannah in this dunya. Are we guaranteed Jannah in this dunya, but we are carrying on like this? Ramadan comes, Ramadan's go, but we do not get God-fearingness. Where are we today? He cried in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that one of his fast can be accepted. One of his fast, where are we today? We fast when Ramadan comes. Eid comes, we celebrate. But do we worry about if our fast is accepted in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we worry about our year after? Do we worry about that journey which has no return? When you go into the qabr, the qabr calls out every day. Awalam ta'alam, that do you not know? Ana baytul dur, that I'm the house of worms. Awalam ta'alam, anna baytul wahda, that I'm the house of loneliness. He calls out, awalam ta'alam, that do you not know? Ana baytul dhul, that I'm the house of darkness. Where are we today? Are we not worried about what's going to happen to us after this? The Sahaba Ikram, they were guaranteed Jannah, but they still cried in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They cried in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that perhaps they will enter Jannah. And they were guaranteed Jannah. Where are we today? Arabic shair comes to mind, whereby it says, لَيْسَ الْعِيدُ لِمَنْ أَكَلَ وَشَرِبَ إِنَّمَا الْعِيدُ لِمَنْ أَخْلَصَ عَمَلُهُ لِلَّهِ. Eid is not for that person that only eats and drinks. But Eid is for that person that makes his actions only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ الْعِيدُ لِمَنْ تَبَخَّرَ بِالْعُودِ إِنَّمَا الْعِيدُ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَلَا يَعُودُ. Eid is not for that person that puts on nice perfumes. But Eid is for that person that repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does not repeat that same sin indeed. Where are we today? The Sahaba Ikram, they have given us so much lessons of the lifestyles that they have lived. But are we taking any lessons from their lifestyles? Respected audience, how are we going to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How are we going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding. Moving on to the third right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is zakat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed this right upon us that we have to give zakah, charity to the poor. It's a means of cleansing your wealth and yourself. But what do we Muslims do today? We consider it as an Islamic tax. As an Islamic tax, we do not want to give this. It's the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has in our wealth. We have to give it, and if not, we will be punished for it. Because that is not yours, it's the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not think that you have worked your whole life for your wealth, so I cannot give it to someone else. Who is the one that gave you that strength to work for that wealth? Who is the one that make you breathe in and out daily? Who is the one that created you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no right in your wealth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Abu Bakr, he fought against the people that never wanted to give zakah in his time. He fought, he killed those people who never wanted to give zakah. Today we take it as an Islamic tax. Why did he stand against that people? Because it's the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knew how important is it. He knew how important is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to fulfill it. Are we giving the importance to the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has placed upon us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ بِمَا أَتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَحْلِهِ هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُمْ بَلْ هُوَ شَرٌ لَهُمْ. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says? وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ إِنْ. Do not think. Do not think. الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ. Those who are stingy. بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. With what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them min fadlihi, from His bounties, huwa khairul lahum, it is good for them. But what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? Bal huwa sharrul lahum, it is bad for them. On the day of Qiyamah, on the day of judgment, when you'll be resurrected in front of your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you'll be asked about this. And those who did not give in the part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the poor, those who did not give charity in the part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the punishment for this? A snake will come to him in the shape of his wealth. A snake will come to him in the shape of his wealth, and it will coil around his neck, and it will press him, and it will start to bite him and say, Ana maluk, ana kanzuk, ana maluk, ana kanzuk. I am your wealth, I am your treasures, I am your wealth, I am your treasures. Respected audience, where are we today? Where are we today, respected audience, Jamaatul Muslimin? As time does not allow me to carry on to the last right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let me just say a few things about Hajj. To do it, if you have the means to do so. If you do not have the means, it's not compulsory upon you to do it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this easy for us as Muslims, as His servants, as His creation. That if you have the means, you should do so. But if you do not have the means, don't break yourself. Ad-deen yusr. The deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is easy. Do not make it hard upon yourself. But what do we do as Muslims nowadays when we have the money to go for Hajj? Would we go for Hajj? No. We rather invest in our businesses. And if we go for Hajj, we go for business. We go to see the place. Is that what Hajj is all about? Is that what Hajj is all about? Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam cried for 6 hours on Mina for his ummah. Today we go for half an hour and come back. Is that the Hajj we are supposed to do? Where are we today, Jamaat Muslimin? But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me in you the tawfiq and the hidayah to understand this and to act upon whatever I've said. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the love in our hearts for those who love Allah and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if there is anything I have said that may offend anyone, make me maaf, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me. And shahidu an la ilaha illallah, shahidu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. وما توفيقي إلا بالله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. The collection on Friday, there's a few announcements that I